Hello and welcome to this webcast on how to measure security culture is different from counting employees. This is a brief teaser of the talk I will be giving at the RSA conference in Singapore later this summer. My name is Kai Roer, and I am the founder and CEO of CLTRe. And over the past 20 years, I have collected a lot of different kinds of experience in security, communication, and leadership. Experience and knowledge that I use today in my job to improve security cultures for companies and organizations around the world. I also produce books and write columns and stuff like that. And as you will be seeing in Singapore, I also do conferences and talks. But today, this is not about me. This is about security culture. And mainly the question, how can we measure culture? How can we understand and improve security culture in a way that makes sense for organizations and that is not only counting the number of employees attending a particular training, but shows and demonstrates the effectiveness of the security culture program that you and your colleagues implement at your organizations. Basically, I am asking and answering the question, how long is a fish? Now, think about that. A fish, how long is it, right? So the answer to that depends on a lot of things. For example, the fish itself. And then looking at the fish itself, the answer will depend on the species. If it's a tuna, it is reasonable to believe it's a bigger thing than if it's a small, I don't know, bass, for example. But more importantly, this question also is related to the eye of the beholder, the fisherman. If you have ever seen a fisherman telling you the story of that fish he caught last night or last vacation or whatever, then watch his hands as he explains the size of this fish. Every time he tells that story, the fish tends to be larger than the last time. The problem with this, then, how long is the fish, is that we need a standard. We need a way to figure out what are we talking about. When it comes to fish itself, we can, for example, use a standard metric called meters or centimeters or foot or tons, or we can use weight. The challenge when it comes to measuring culture is, what kind of standard or metrics are there available? And my talk is exactly about that. What kind of standard or metrics do we have? So one of the things I will be discussing is the glass. Is it half full, half empty, or as some salespeople would say, how much ice do you want with that water, sir? My take on this is not the ice or the amount of water or whether or not it's half full or half empty. My question is, what is the actual size of that particular glass? As you can see here in my slide here, the size of the glass depends on what glass it is. So we have a fishbowl here. This fishbowl probably contains more water than the drinking glass next to it, and the other glasses as well. All of us who have ever seen or used a glass, and I bet you have, know that the size of glass dictates how much water is in there. But the problem is that unless we talk about the exact same glass, we don't really know how much water it is. Which is why we need to figure out a way to measure the same thing over and over so that we can know that particular culture consists of, for example, seven different traits, as we see in the culture toolkit, where the standard is using attitudes, norms, compliance, communication, behaviors, and responsibilities, to name a few of those. Instead of having a large number of different kinds of glasses and not really understanding or even discussing the same thing, in order to measure culture, I believe that we need a standard of measurement, one single metric that will help us improve the dialogue we have about how we discuss security culture. To do that, we need to move away from technology and away from ad hoc metrics and vanity metrics, as you see when we're counting employees conducting a training. And we need to move towards a standard where we agree on these are the characteristics that are used when we discuss and understand culture. Using a standard, we are suddenly available to compare apples with apples. And comparing the same thing every single time enables us to build benchmarks and enables us to build scales where we can understand how well are we and our organization doing when it comes to security cultures. And we can compare to other organizations in our own industry. For example, on this slide, we see how different sectors within the bank and finance industry is doing. And not surprisingly, using the same scale, measuring the same things across more than 10,000 employees in 38 different companies in several countries, we see that there are differences between different industry sectors. Using them as standard or metric allows us to compare and then understand that, for example, fund management is in fact doing worse when it comes to security culture than monetary intermediation. This kind of knowledge helps us understand or at least discuss whether or not we can expect funds management to do worse, or if we think that they should actually be doing better. Without a standard metric, we don't really know because we are comparing half full or half empty glasses without discussing the size of the glass. In addition to the sense of definitions and digging into what security culture is and how it works, I will also be sharing some of the results from our recent research. Our research was conducted this year and published now in May and is freely available. One of the findings that I will be sharing in Singapore is how age influences security behavior and risk acceptance of individuals in an organization. As we see here, the older you get, the better security culture you have. Now, that is a very arrogant kind of statement, that age matters. And until today, we used to think that young people would have a better security culture because a lot of young people know how to use and apply technology. Think of it. My son, 15 years now, he grew up with computers and iPhones and all these devices, making me and a lot of other people out there think that these young people growing up with all this technology, they also will understand and behave differently when it comes to security. Our research shows that this idea is flawed and wrong. In fact, young people behave worse when it comes to security and when it comes to risk on online systems than older people do. This is why we do research, and this and other kinds of results I will be sharing in my talk in Singapore in July. I hope to see you there because I want to not only share our findings, but also engage in dialogue with you and other people who care about this topic. So please join the talk at RSA. And if you want to reach out with questions or anything in before that, these are my contact details. Thank you.